Doctor Who, Tyler Victorious, The Night, The Fool, and The Dead. The first novel out inside the Tyler Victorious storyline. And I just read it, all of it. Thought it's a bit iffy. So pre-warned if you hear some coughing or go a little bit, pre-warned. But the one thing that really strikes me about this novel, and it's a good novel, is that at the beginning and most of this novel, it kind of just felt like a regular Doctor Who story that is set in the dark times. And you're thinking, is this whole Tyler Victorious story just dealing with the factor that the dark, that they want to explore the dark times and using three doctors as a way to explore, and here's the adventure, three doctors, three adventures, plus some audio dramas and comics to combine with those doctors, to explore that era. Because at the beginning I thought, okay, this is it. I mean, the tenth doctor is very stern. He's very stern. He's still acting like ten and all that kind of stuff, but he's more like a stern type of 10 doctor. It's right after Wars of Mars. There's a few hints of what happened after Wars of Mars. There's a Captain Adelaide reference at the beginning and him mentioning like, oh yeah, I just went to Mars. So he's like, push off Mars and all that, so you know, time frame wise. But then the story keeps going, and you're like, okay, got, you know, Brian the Ood, who's like an assassin and all that, and you're like, okay, that's kind of neat. Once again, just feels like a, it feels like an episode of the show that would kind of, that now got made, you know what I mean? But then, like, the last three chapters happened? Where, when they told us about this title of Victorious thing, they said, oh, the comics are going to be separate, and the audio dramas, and the novels, and the Dalek animated show, they're all going to be separate. They're not going to be super interconnected. Bullshit. Bullshit. That's like saying, oh, Sybil, you don't have to watch Endgame to understand. You don't need to watch any of the MCU films to understand Endgame. Do you though? Do you? I mean, I try not to hit spoilers here because I understand. So it's a novel. There's a lot of pages attached to the things. There's a lot of words. Do I want to spoil the last like three pages? The last three chapters, because here's the thing, if you want to ask what are the essential ones, like if you're not going to buy all of them, which ones which are the main ones, this is the first one I will say, because what is, okay, fuck it, I'm going to spoil it, pre-warn, you know, do I think it's a good read, it is a good read, but you should read it for like the last like three, four chapters. Because it's really, this is feels like now the Tyler Victorious story is moving. The title of it, and feels like if you're a person who's going to trying to read or listen or watch or play any part of the Tyler Victorious story, this is going to be the award in the next novel, which is called All flesh and glass. So pre-warn, all that. If you want to know, I'll just say it. So pre-warn. I try to have it home for people. It's a good way to pick it up. Here's the thing. This is the one when 10 becomes officially the title of Victorious. Like, this is when he is, because he does the whole, like, he did the whole, you know, hey, there was these people with time, and I'm part of that race, and there was a great time war, and blah, 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 but they're all dead but me, so I can kind of do whatever the fuck I want, and da, 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 da. Like, that is said. Like, that is happened. And you're like, wait, are we hitting this point? Are we hitting the point where 10 is going to be the bad guy in all this? which is kind of just assume, right? Which hurts. Because 10's my favorite. I don't want 10's a villain, but anyway. And you're like, the more and more he says, like, he kind of doesn't care about, like, he's like, I'm white, you know? And bugger whatever anyone else thinks. And the more that happens, like, we're introduced to, I think, one of the main villains called the problem with reading a novel, you're kind of trying to announce the names. They're the cloaky type villains that are in, that's on, like, I think, The Master. They were in that Doctor Who short for Tyler Victorious for the newsletter. They're in this. It's all that. They're basically Death. And he's like Pusha. And he, you know, he kind of wipes them out. A couple of the characters get killed off. He gets angry and all that. And you're, and the more and more you get all that, he just feels like, not that he's more victorious. He feels he's above everything. And you feel the threat and feel how scary it is that he has this kind of level of power towards it. Now, the ending is the award thing. Like, the ending of this, like, the last chapter of this is like, if you're going to follow everything, this is going to be the award. All flesh and glass is going to be the award for following all this, right? And that is this. The TARDIS gets interrupted. Brian the Ood and the Doctor in the Time Lord Victorious outfit, him looking, you know, he's on, it's the poster, it's the main poster, he's wearing the Time Lord Victorious gear, right? So what happens is there's a monitor, the monitor's on, and 8 shows up, and it's 8, and you're like, wait, what? I know that was 3 and I was on the cover for all, but wait, what? And he's in a army, and he has teamed up with the Daleks. And you're like, oh shit. 2. And then a coffin, like a vampire type coffin has showed up, and it's 9. And then there's vampires, which is connected to the Doctor Who magazine story that's happening. So your head's thinking, okay, how is this all going to be connected? All right now, you're like, oh my god, I went there, you know, I went the, like, you know, none, at this point in time, none of the 8 audio dramas have showed up, so we don't know how it's all connected. But with 9th level stuff, like, the vampires and the time, like, where's Woes and all that kind of situation, it kind of makes you feel the speculation. Like, I would not be shocked. That, because the mice, and I love this line that 10 says, and that is, no one tells me what to do, even me. So applying that, not even my past self is going to stop me. And you're like, okay, this is a full-on threat. This is a full-on, like, Alon Z, please, for the love of God, like, hell, like, we, yeah, like, I have a feeling, this is a speculation. Because Brian the Ood shows up in, I think, the first one, the first 8 Doctor audio drama. And that is that, I'm wondering if he's going to be the Nick Fury. That he knows the Doctor is going to go too far. He knows 10 is going to go too far. So he tells 8 and 9. And I have a speculation because of the Titan comics. He tells his past current self that this is going to happen. You need to stop yourself. And it's going to be very interesting. Very interesting. And I mean, here's the thing: the next ones are on the same day. There's actually 3 things coming out on the same day. We have 2 audio dramas doing with the Master, and short trips in the next, and the final contribution of Titan Comics with the Defenders of the Daleks. It's which is also featuring 10. It's you just start sick as a fan of the show and the defense, you know, and fan of 10 and the fan of the Doctor, you start thinking all these speculations, all this thing. Comment below if you read this. Comment below, what do you think? Like, just I'm just having a home those last few pages, because the rest of it just feels like a standard Doctor Who story that you feel like, okay, this is kind of neat. This is kind of, yeah, if it was TV, I actually quite like this episode kind of thing. But the ending, nine vampires, eight with Daleks, with a evil 10. That's just, if that's not interesting, I don't know what is.